to make those rainbows in my mind. When I think of you sometime, and I want to spend some time with you, just the two of us. We can make it if we try.
Version of you did after gripping him tight and racing him from perdition. They did what they were told. But not you. Not the one off the line with a crack in his chassis.
Destiny, God's plan. It's all a bunch of lies, you poor stupid son of a bitch. You know what's real?
You asked, what about all of this is real?
People. Families. That's real.
We are.
His true weakness is revealed.
He has his weakness. He likes you.
I'm gonna cure you of your human weakness.
He's in love.
I love you.
I knew you.
Take what you need, say your goodbye.
Bring him back now.
You're gonna bring him back.
Cass, you gotta bring him back.
Cry.
This is me, one day into watching Supernatural.
This is me, 1 month into watching Supernatural.
This is me, 6 months into watching Supernatural. Damn it, Cass!
Lou, just kind of checking in. But I also wanted to talk about something that's really important to me. I know sometimes you feel like you can't fight, and I know sometimes you feel like you just can't love yourself. And when that happens, I want you to remember that you're enough. You're enough as you are. You're a brave, powerful soul. I'm sorry for your battles, but I'm proud of you that you're battling daily and you're still here. You inspire people, man, so never forget that. Just remember that you did it. You saved your life. I was just here to let you know you could do it. You know, you can't put the oxygen mask on the guy next to you if you don't put it on yourself first. So never forget you have that strength. You learned to love yourself first. So you're not alone. You have support and love, but you did it. Keep fighting. Love yourself first. And know you're enough. All right. I'll check back in soon. Love you. All right.
Do you ever just watch this scene? Because they're happy here, even if only for a few minutes. And this is the kind of ending we should have gotten. Also,
hey Dean, if you're tired, why don't you go to bed? I'm not tired.
That's such a dad thing to say. I'm not tired, just rest in my eyes.
Ooh.
Jackpot.
Like, I love all four of them just living together in the bunker.
All right, well, I say let's call it. Movie night?
Doing movie nights.
Murray, will you please raise your right hand?
I do. Yes, Your Honor.
Yep.
Can you tell me the reason for your name change?
Yes, Your Honor. I was requesting a name change because I am transgender.
All right. Is it spelled correctly? What is Clay Jensen, J-E-N-S-E-N, Murray, M-U-R-R-A-Y?
Yes, Your Honor.
Mr. Murray, this will be ready for you to pick up anytime after this morning, all right?
Wonderful. Thank you, Your Honor. Okay, so I thought my heart was gonna, like, literally leave my chest. Oh my god, but it's done. I said I wasn't gonna cry. Okay, I'm good. I'm good. I
wanna hold them like they do in Texas, please. Fold them, let them hit me, raise it, baby, stay with me.
I love it. Love it.
to walk around the house and just yell Sammy all the time.
Is there anyone in the house named Sammy?
Nope. Great. There is not.
Is this a yell? Like you stub your toe and you're like, Sam! Or is this just like making eggs and being like, Sammy! That's it? Sammy! Just the salt. You're a bad thing.
My friend.
I don't need your opinion.
I don't need it.
Do what I fucking want.
You can count on me like 1, 2.
I'm a crackhead. I'm a crackhead.
I would always argue that Cass was a bottom until I saw this scene.
Seen two ugly best friends when one of them has a red aesthetic with darker overtones and enough trauma to make them feel like they're unworthy of love, and the other has a blue aesthetic with lighter overtones and a definite savior complex that has put their physical and mental well-being in danger multiple times and is also funny. Both of them gotta be pretty.
What's wrong with me? Why do I feel like this?
Down south, hood baby, make all the girls go crazy, go stoop, look up, down to the side, walk.
Oh shit! Oh shit!
You should show me some respect. I dragged you out of hell, I can throw you back in.
Look at Dean being a bottom.
You shot me.
The next time you summon me, you might want to make sure you're decent. Flirt.
Ooh. Well, don't tell me you put on your birthday suit just for me. Well, chop chop. Spells to do, demons to name.
Hi. Oh. I can help. You keep your clothing over here.
I am sorry. What are you doing?
I'm helping.
Hey, let's watch a few supernatural scenes.
Dean, why don't you touch up your car before you get rust? I wouldn't have given you the damn thing if I thought you were going to ruin it.
Well, you don't remember, do you? You ran away on my watch. I looked everywhere for you. I thought you were dead. And when Dad came home, he took you to a freaking baseball game?
Yeah. What would that do with you on your birthday?
You ever been really hungry? I mean, haven't eaten in days hungry? Yeah, my entire life. You've protected me. From Dad? From Lucifer?
All that crap you've done to me about protecting Sam, that was his crap. He's the one who couldn't protect his family. Who wasn't there for Sam? I always was. He wasn't there.
Anyways, fuck John Winchester.
It was...
relations at all. What the hell is this, Agent?
I'm just doing my job, Mr. McKinley.
By suggesting my daughter was a slut.
I'll admit that thought crossed my mind. Then I came here and I smelled the deceit and the beatings and the shame that pervade this home. And you know what? I don't blame Rose anymore. No wonder she put on that skank outfit and went out there looking for validation. Right into the arms of the monster that killed her. Joe, who did this? Joe! Who did this?
That's some spicy trauma projection there, Dean. You got some shit you gotta get off your chest? You smelled the beatings. Are you familiar with that sensation? Anyways, f*** John Winchester.
It's okay. You can laugh. It's funny.
The joke was, it's kind of like a physical pantomime joke. But I told it to my grandmother. And here's the joke. I bet I can make you come with one finger.
Guys, Dean Benny just went canon again because Ty Olson, who plays Benny, confirmed it in a cameo, like, multiple times. He just kept saying it. I need to show you this.
You asked for me to say Dean Benny is canon. I can't say that. I can't. I can say Benny Dean is canon because it sounds more like Billie Jean and it puts Benny in the front, so Benny Dean is definitely canon. I mean, like, big-ass cannons, like the ones on the sides of vampire ships that shoot the big lead balls. Bean Denny is canon. Bean Denny is canon. Bean Denny is canon.